You probably remember the version we launched a couple of months back. This version MyQ 8.2 LTS. This release contains lots of new features. And one of the main game changers, we call that features, was actually making MyQ Web UI accessible.
At MyQ, it's always been a part of our core to design products that's usable to everyone. And so we found in the market that we have people with some disabilities, with some visual impairments, and some challenges to using and interacting with the web and our application as such. And so we started our research process, started to research users, how to interact with the web, understanding what is the need out there when it comes to users with some impairments, which makes it difficult for them to use web applications. And that's how the project started. We then approached a very reputable company in Germany called Twin Cubes, and they actually specialize in web accessibility for users with disabilities in accordance with the WCAG, which is specifically designed for users and giving us guidelines on how to develop the web interface to be more accessible to all users with all disabilities.
And we spent many hours by consultation with them. The guys there were ready, were very open. They exactly understood what we need, and they helped us with every step. They helped us testing the software, making the recommendations, making how to make the software better and actually compliant towards the accessibility. The total project consumed for about half a year. And I believe we succeeded, because on the very end, the company has the consultant company has performed the tests. They included the third-party consultant or third-party testers who actually tested the environment, and we received a certificate.
We managed to achieve a WCAG 2.1 AA accreditation, as well as the BITV accreditation, which actually makes our software one of the very, very few managed print providers or managed print software out there that actually achieves this type of accreditation. And it also allows us to now being able to put a product out there that can actually help users with disabilities. It was a very complex task. WCAG is designed for initially more designed towards web pages, because you've got a very lot of different layers and complexity in these layers within our web application. It's not just a simple web page where you click, it takes you to the next section. With us, there's actually settings. You need to get feedback as you change the settings, as the user uploads a print job, as the user changes color, he changes simplex, duplex, from a user perspective. Then also we had to make sure that our software are also accessible for administrators. You need to consider that out there, there might be some people with disability that's actually administrators that would like to be an administrator of the MyQ software. So then it becomes even more complex, because now you need to make sure that that user can fully navigate that web application, the MyQ web application, and fully understand how to configure even complex settings, complex policies, and so forth. Now, once you did these improvements, you also need to make sure that not only it complies with web accessibility, but that the core of the product, that the initial settings that you made to make it more enhanceable for the user, that it doesn't affect the actual product itself and actual operation of the product in the code in the background. So with this, we're a very complex task, but I think it was well worth it if you look at what we are able to offer our users with disability now, and then also the VITV and the WCAG accreditation that we got with it.
But then we found out that we can actually carry on. Let's see how the software is used by the people who have some obstacles to enter the normal office working environment. So we decided to find out someone who will actually can help us with that, who has such experience. We get an opportunity to meet incredible guy, Petr Haluska. He's involved in lots of projects. He organized the car races. He's working on on some simulator for the cars, helicopters, and so on for the people who actually cannot see. When I heard about this for the first time, he was actually making these car races. I said, how this is possible that the blind person is driving a car and driving cars so fast? It's amazing. And I said, that would be great cooperation with that guy because he's open-minded. We started to communicate. We provide him the remote access to the MyQ web UI. He was able to test, play with this environment using the tools he's normally using. He said, yeah, it's working quite nice. I still need to explain some parts, but because he's not MyQ user, he's never seen MyQ before. So we decided, okay, let's come here. Let's come to the office. We can, you know, make some tests. We can explain you how the stuff works. You can try to print. You can try to scan, copy whatever you need. Peter came to our office. We had 4 hours together where we tried to set up the environment for him. Where we tried several scenarios. He should be now able to print via his laptop through the MyQ to the device, then take a patch, get to the printer, get these prints out, but also log in and then again perform another actions to copy or scan the document to his mailbox. He was using his actually narrator, which was telling him what the content of the screen, so he was able to operate, to use his keyboard and operate what he needed. Then we moved to the device and we needed to face the experience that the user actually cannot see anything what is located on the screen panel. And the last part we wanted to test was the using the mobile app. We made this application accessible, so every field, every part is described well. Peter was very excited about that because he said, so I don't need to operate the device. I don't need to stand at the device. I don't need to place any stickers and so on. I said, no, you can actually do anything from your phone.
Dovolím si říct, že je na špici ledovce pomyslném, neboť opravdu každá kolonka, každá ta informace lze pohodlně prostě z křesla u počítače prostě ovládat plně kompatibilně, nemám s tím problém. Takže dovolím si říct, že to MyQ prostředí je naprosto připravený, je to dospělé prostředí pro nevidomé. To MyQ prostředí zatím stojí lidi, že jo? To prostředí samo nevznikne, takže hlavně si vážím těch lidí, těch hlav, který to vymysleli, protože něco vymyslet, co není, tak je o vývoji, o nějaké trpělivosti, o představě a o tom to, co mají v hlavě, tak prostě dát do praxe, do reálných měřítek, aby to tak fungovalo, tak jak si oni řeknou, nebo aspoň přibližně. A myslím si, že to prostředí má obrovskou hodnotu a myslím si, že to, jak říkáme, nebo říkáte, že to zrychlí a efektivní jakoby spolupráci, koordinaci těch firm a tak dále, respektive těch lidí v těch firmách.
To be honest, we were shocked somehow, sometimes, or very surprised, because at that moment we realized how is it for the people who are having such visual impairments. How is it for them to work in the office? These people have to be independent. They need to have the software which is kind of friendly to them. And since he started to use it, there were many ideas coming out just in a few seconds where we seen him working with that we should improve that would be better. There is, I would say, quite a long list now how to improve MyQ. We did a very good job until now. The web UI is ready for readers to use. It's ready for Microsoft Cortana, which is integrated in the system, so it can quite nicely read the content of the web UI of the screen, so user feels comfortable.
A za mě, pokud mám mluvit k tomuto zařízení a vůbec té internetové platformě nebo toho prostředí, tak musím říct, že je to velice přívětivý, efektivní, přehledný je to. A konstatuji jenom zodpovědně to, že kdyby se tady posadil i někdo jiný, nevědomý a trošičku měl minimální znalosti ohledně uživatelských schopností a zkrátka měl chuť nebo bude to potřebovat ke své profesi, že to prostředí je adekvátně připravený k použití už teď. To znamená, ten nevědomý přijde, přihlásí se, ten hlasový výstup ho provází a pokud je to prostředí přehledný, není to krkolomný, tak prostě ten nevědomý dokáže právoplatně prostě pracovat tak, jako kdyby ten člověk viděl.
We actually invited also a tester for this session. The tester is actually confirming that the software is working well before we actually officially release that. And it was one of his first experience to meeting someone who is completely blind and cannot actually operate the MyQ web environment without seeing any line or any button. And it was also a great experience for him.
Tak rozhodně to byla zajímavá zkušenost, protože když my to testujeme vlastně u nás v testovacím prostředí, tak testujeme podle toho, jak si vlastně představujeme, že by to ty uživatelé mohli používat. A když tady právě vidím, jak to reálně ty uživatelé používají, tak je to trošku jiný, ale právě pomůže nám to zlepšovat ty procesy, abychom to testovali vlastně v co nejautentičtějším prostředí. Tak z začátku jsem si musel zvykat na to předčítání toho softwaru, který nevědomí pomáhá. To, co já vidím na té obrazovce a potřebuju vlastně ten výstup, aby se mohli orientovat, takže na to jsem si chvilku zvykal, protože vlastně to mi říká něco, na co nejsem vlastně zvyklý, takže z začátku to bylo takový právě rušivý pro nás.
On vlastně, nebo vy jste zvyklí, 85% představuje zrak, jo? To znamená, vy mrknete, vidíte a provedete úkon, jo? Na základě nějakých vlivů nebo prostě to, co vám ten počítač řekne, tak vy uděláte mžiku a ten člověk vlastně jako, proč už to dávno neudělal, že jo? Když už to vidím, že jo? A pak jakoby teprve, ty jo, on je vlastně slepej, že jo? Takže...
So, I would say it was great experience meeting Better testing our software here. It actually confirms what we have done previously, that what we developed work. I would say there is still some space where we can fine-tune because it was actually the first time we were facing the experience of the, let's say, blind tester. Someone who is giving us the feedback directly, even he didn't need to talk because we were watching what actually he's doing. Some actions he was able to perform very easily, but some actions require some more effort. I believe we can improve it a little bit more to face an even better experience.
So for us, it's also a great achievement that we can now make sure that users that may be blind or got some visual impairment or something like that can now use our product and feel confident in using it. So overall, it's been a great experience, and we also look forward to continuing on this path and make sure that our future products and our future releases also comply with these standards so that we can make sure that our users have an excellent experience when using the MyQ product.
The whole idea of this is making the software personalized for the users. And we don't want to distinguish between the users who are actually blind and who can use the software. So we are actually going in the same railways of the personalization, but we are making the software more accessible to anyone. So in these terms, we support the equality. We would like to allow any employee working in the office using the printing device to be able actually to perform any action without asking anyone to help with him or without excluding them from some part of workflows or processes. So people like Peter should be able to use their printing device, mobile phone and PC without any limits, same as any other employees in the company.